I'm in the middle of a show.
Oh, good for you.
Okay, who are you?
Whoa, I am the god of all things Taurus. I am going on. Get out of town, that's totally cool.
You said that you're Quantum Joe?
Why, you heard me?
Yes, you're that world famous traveler, explorer, adventurer. You're that Quantum Joe.
Oh, I'm a tour guide now. This is my runaway tour group right here.
I cannot believe I'm meeting you in person.
What?
Joy.
Joy.
Huge fan.
What did I say to you, Joy? I am so sorry I interrupted your show.
Oh my goodness, don't even worry about it.
Oh, I had an idea.
Okay, why don't you stay for the show?
Of course I will. My tour group's here already. Well, we'll stay. We'll watch the show.
No, you can be in the show.
What?
Yeah, you can be like a celebrity guest.
Get out! Yeah. I would love to do that. That's fine. How about you?
Everyone, Quantum Joe is going to help us with the merch!
Hey!
Woo!
There's really birds in the show?
Oh yeah, it's a whole bird show.
Are they angry birds? No, we can't stay. We're really busy. I did not know there were birds.
You're busy.
No, come on, get away from me. Get away from me.
No, you're just chickens.
Those are escapees from Colonel Sanders.
Oh yeah, what is going on?
You need to know something. I have fun.
What's Bob?
Bob! Fear of birds! I am terrified of what is that?
It's okay, this is Poe. He's a collared raven. You find him in Africa. You don't have to be afraid of him.
He's got my flag! That's my tour flag!
No!
You talk my tour group. Don't follow the flag. What do you do with my flag?
I'm sorry you took it really far back there. I'm too sorry. You have another one?
No! And my tour group isn't going to follow me, yes?
I'm sure. Okay, I can get it after
the show. He's back.
Oh, it's a good thing. They're really smart. You could probably get
it. That's my step.
No.
That's my step.
No.
Sorry. Really? He took my flag and my stick.
I'm sorry.
What, does he work for the IRS?
Maybe you should take it as a sign.
A sign?
A sign that you should stay?
No, you've got birds here and they take stuff.
Oh, come on, we all want Quantum Joe to stay, right?
All right, I tell you what, we will stay under one condition.
Okay.
There is one thing I know everybody would love to see. A little bird.
We have little birds.
Riding a bicycle. That is so cute with the red light.
We like to focus on natural behaviors.
What's more natural than a bird on a bike?
No, they you see in the wild.
Yes.
Okay, you've seen a bird ride a bike in the wild.
Yeah.
When?
In the 70s. Say some of these people saw it.
I'm sorry. No birds on bikes. But I have something even better.
What?
A very talented parrot coming out here center stage.
You're going to bring a parrot out here?
Mm-hmm.
No, I really have to stand at a distance or hide. I cannot be close to a bird.
Okay. Hide over by the tree.
Hide by the tree. By that tree.
Yeah.
Will I be safe?
Yeah, birds hate trees.
Oh, okay.
Now, how many of you have heard of talking parrots before? Yeah, I'm sure most of you have. Now, they come as a bit of a surprise. A talking for a parrot is kind of a natural behavior, but they're not talking like you and I are. What they're doing is copying or mimicking sounds they hear in their environment. Thank you, Bradley. Now, when they're in the wild, they'll learn to imitate the sounds of their parents or their flock mates, but when they're in home, well, that is when they might learn to imitate human sounds, which to us sounds a lot like talking. Now, we've been joined by an excellent mimicker. This is Groucho. And Groucho, why don't we start off by giving everyone a nice big hello? Now, Groucho is a yellow-named Amazon parrot. You normally find these birds in the forests of Central America, but not Groucho. Groucho's lived around people his entire life. He has learned to take that mimicry to a whole new level. We're going to see if he'll show some of that off.
Mama,
then you can sing any other song you want.
Before she goes back in, you're the splash zone. Yeah. So, Southern
just flew inches over your head. Our volunteers, a big round of applause.
Okay, come on. The bird looks like a pterodactyl. My tour group is very brave.
It is awesome.
All of them.
Joe, you can be that brave.
What are you talking about?
You can be brave from the next bird.
What?
It's a baby bird.
You have a baby bird?
Yes.
If you have a baby bird, I can... Wait a minute. Can the baby bird fly?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you know what? My tour group has been so brave, I'm gonna be brave. Let's have the baby bird fly out here and land right here on my finger. How about that?
No.
Why no? You just had a bird fly out and take money from him.
That was a different bird.
Yeah, this is a baby bird. Do you all want to see a baby bird land on my finger? Look at the support from my tour group. Like this?
Okay. You have to call him by his name.
By his name?
It's Baby Elvis.
Baby Elvis?
Yes. He's gonna come from the tall window over there.
From over there?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So wait, I just call out Baby Elvis and he knows the land on my hand?
Oh, yeah.
People, get out your cameras. This is where dreams come true. Baby Elvis! Everybody, call him out!
Baby Elvis!
That was really loud.
Yeah, it was good.
I don't see it. That bird ate Baby Elvis.
Joe, where are you going?
That bird ate Baby Elvis.
Joe, that's Baby Elvis!
That's a baby?
Yes, he's a baby king vulture!
A vulture? You didn't tell me it was going to be a vulture, much less their king.
Oh, he's the king of the vultures. He's a king vulture. Am I taking over?
Yeah, I'm not touching a vulture.
Okay, well, king vultures, you find these birds in America, and they are some of the most beautiful vultures in the world. Now, Elvis is almost completely mature. When he is totally mature, his entire body is going to be covered in those creamy white feathers. His head will be more orange, yellow, maybe even a little purple, and gorgeous. And Joe, I didn't think he'd be afraid of a vulture. You know the Epeirian.
They eat the luggage you bring on an airplane?
Carrion, the red is of animals that have died in the wild.
Okay, that's gross.
It's kind of gross. But vultures, they come along, they clean up all that mess, they stop the spread of disease, and you know nothing in nature is ever wasted, so we call them nature's recyclers.
Well, I recycle.
Oh, you recycle?
Oh, my turkeys do.
Well, you know, if everybody recycled like you and this gorgeous vulture, well, this earth would be a much cleaner place. Elvis, you're perfect. Okay. You know where to go. And that was Elvis, our baby king vulture.
People, if you're walking around today and you see Elvis flying above you, look alive, people, look alive. The bird was ginormous.
Sorry, I have a smaller bird.
Well, that's what I was hoping for.
All right, it's a hawk. He's going to fly
I was not what I was hoping for. A hawk is a bird of prey. We just had a vulture. My tour group doesn't want to see a hawk.
Part of the United States, places like Texas, Arizona, New Mexico. You find them in the desert. The Marisaks, they're unique. They're unique because they live and hunt in family groups. Two or more of these birds will team up together, take down something up to the size of a jackrabbit. And that is an excellent survival strategy, especially for that harsh desert environment where you find them. And you know they need that extra edge to survive because 75% of all birds of prey hatched in the wild, 75%, they don't make it past their first year of life.
Why?
Well, a lot of it is due to natural causes, but a lot of these birds are getting shot.
But I thought that was illegal to shoot bird of prey.
It is illegal. It's a good thing. They help control our rodent populations. It's just one of the many reasons we love having them around. All right. Eating your last of your goodies. Bradley's moved on you. Their vision is about 3 to 4 times better than our own. natural behavior. All right. All right, let's see if you can hit the people in front.
Why we haven't had an ounce or a rat here in the company.
Oh.
Great, you had that bad rat
infestation. It was like a month ago.
Was that a month ago?
Yeah, it was terrible.
We had a lot of rats.
There were rats climbing all over the walls.
Oh, really?
Yeah, everywhere you looked.
I know I couldn't bring burgers here because there were rats everywhere.
It was so really bad. It was really gross.
Yeah.
There they are.
Just when you thought that they were coming out.
Yeah. I was there.
Yeah. It was crazy.
Glad you're here now. I have no idea birds can be beneficial.
Beautiful.
Really?
That brings us to our next bird. One of the most beautiful birds found in all of Africa. It's called a crown crane. We have one joining us around the corner with Adam. Watch as this bird flies over here. Look at the 6-foot wingspan. Frasier Crane. Now, crown cranes, they get their name from that tuft of golden feathers on top of their head. Hey, Joe, is he here? You want to feed him?
No, he's big. I'll watch him feed him.
Oh, come on, we all want to see Joe feed a bird.
All right, I'll try. What do I do?
All right, you're going to make a bowl with your hands.
A bowl, like this?
Perfect.
What happens?
Frasier's going to come and eat.
Are you kidding me? He's bad.
It's okay.
Oh my gosh, he's right here. Oh, I'm feeding a bird. I'm going to love to see this guy out in the wilds of Africa, running around with his buddies. That would be something.
Well, that would be amazing. Unfortunately, it's a really tough sight to find.
Why?
Well, crown cranes, they struggle in the wild due to things like pollution, habitat loss, even poaching.
Oh, I can't imagine a world without beautiful creatures like this in it.
All right, Joe, that's why it's up to all of us to help protect them.
And protect them we will. Right, folks? Wow. And those are all feathers on his head?
Oh, yeah. Everything on a bird is feathers, even the eyelashes.
They have eyelashes?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I had no idea it was so tough on birds out there.
Oh. It is tough on a lot of animals, but I don't want to bring everybody down. There are plenty of bright spots on that conservation horizon.
Well, tell us a bright spot.
Okay, well, how about the story of the national symbol of the United States of America?
What?
The bald eagle, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, my God.
Joe, this is the living symbol of one of the greatest conservation success stories of our lives. You see, not long ago, bald eagles were in danger of extinction. Their numbers had dropped so low that many feared future generations would never get to see a bird like this in the wild. But that's when something incredible happened, because people took notice, they took action, they cleaned up waterways for eagles to fish, and they stopped using a chemical pesticide, DDT, which was the reason for their decline.
People made the difference by cleaning up the environment?
That's right. Everybody's efforts paid off. Eagle numbers rose so high, they're no longer considered in danger of extinction. Wildlife just by doing something simple like cleaning up our own environment.
Well, I am really glad you asked me to stay. I lost my flag and my stick, but I found hope. What is that?
What is it? It's Cody. He has something for you. Okay, come over here. Make a bowl with your hands so you can pick up your feather crane.
Like this?
Yeah. Hey, Cody.
Are you going to give that to me? You know what? The world is our greatest gift, and it's up to all of us to preserve it.
That is well said, and you know, we as humans, we're the only species. species on this planet that have the ability to do that. And it just takes simple things like conserving or recycling or supporting conservation programs.
Oh, like Disney's Conservation Fund, the Disney's Animal Kingdom.
That's right. It's programs like that that can help save this planet for all the beautiful creatures that live here.
Up here, we'd like to leave you with this wish. May your hearts take flight and your spirits soar forever.